This is Lake Monroe. Here in the heart of southern Indiana, just south of Bloomington, you can find one of America's oldest and most beautiful outdoor destinations. Lake Monroe was formed over 20,000 years ago as the earth warmed and the last glacial ice sheet retreated. The ice sheet, which was nearly 2 miles thick, gouged the earth's surface to create the lake basin. Then trillions of gallons of glacial meltwater ran down and filled the basin to the levels we see today. This glacial melt is why, even in the summer, it never reaches above 38 degrees Fahrenheit. Some scientists, mostly Indiana scientists, say that Lake Monroe is the first of the Great Lakes of North America to emerge in the Holocene era, and you can still find Lake Monroe listed in some Indiana textbooks as the sixth Great Lake. Whether Lake Monroe is one of the Great Lakes or not, it is a rich, biodiverse habitat. The lake is home to over 70 varieties of fish and countless huntable game and wildlife, including the elusive barking possum and the three-toed kineater. The lake is massive, the eighth largest lake in Indiana and the seventh largest lake in the United States, and it contains over 850 hectares of water. That's almost as much as 25 Olympic swimming pools. Unique among the Great Lakes, Lake Monroe contains 18 varieties of Asian carp, more than anywhere else in the world. This invasive species is choking out native fish and irreparably altering the ancient and delicate ecology of the lake. The carp found their way into the lake around 20 years ago when many people in the nearby town of Bloomington began buying baby carps as pets and then flushing them down the drain when they became too large and unwieldy. Scientists and biologists are trying to find ways to control or eliminate the carp population, but the problem is astronomical in scale and it won't be easily resolved. You can do your part by properly disposing of your Asian carp by contacting the Carp Rescue Foundation. Together, we can make this lake American again. The story of how it came to be called Lake Monroe has become the stuff of legends. Apocryphal as it may be, the story goes. In 1817, James Monroe's only son, James Fenimore Monroe, mad with syphilis, was traveling from his home to see a doctor in Chicago when his party chose to camp on the shores of the lake. That evening, a powerful storm rose and nearly destroyed the camp, injuring three and somewhat irrationally enraging James Fenimore Monroe's syphilitic mind. So mad was he that for the next 3 years, he claimed to wage war on the lake. He grew unkempt and made his home in a large beaver lodge, and for reasons still unknown, he became known as the Caligula of Indiana. 3 years later, he emerged from the woods, curiously clean-shaven, and claiming to have achieved victory over the lake. From then on, local residents mockingly called it Lake Monroe. That was its unofficial title until it was officially named Lake Monroe by the Indiana Parks Department in 1998. Today, Lake Monroe is one of North America's premier boating destinations. At any given time, there are more powerboats on Lake Monroe than there are grains of sand on its shore. It's home to the third largest bald eagle sanctuary in the country and is a regular stop for migratory birds, including the near extinct and much sought after chocobo. Over 10,000 people visit the lake every year. That's more than all the other Great Lakes combined. They come here to boat, swim, or just relax on its beautiful beach. Lake Monroe has become an example of how man and beast can coexist, come together, and consume light beer. It's a beacon of collaboration, an ideal synergy between the old and the new, that lights the way for the lakes of the future.
Relax.